For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Hello and welcome to Around the World in 8 Minutes by People's Dispatch. In this show, we bring you stories from people's resistance and struggles across the world. Today we are at Janata Bhavan, New Delhi, where all the communist parties have gathered to protest against the rising prices, the rising unemployment and the economic recession in the country. The communist parties allege these problems are due to the neoliberal economic policies by the far-right-wing Indian government led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. They also allege that this government is not for the people but for the rich in the country. The rich in the country is primarily two big corporates, the Adani and Ambanis. And the communist parties and the opposition allege that this government is actually working for these two companies.
यार ये आर्थिक मंदी इसलिए हो रही है कि देश की जनता के हाथ में खरीदने की क्षमता नहीं है और ये क्षमता घटा पहले आपके नोटबंदी से बाद में जिस तरीके से जीएसटी को लागू किया गया उसके बाद आप जो जिस तरीके से आपकी पब्लिक सेक्टर को सार्वजनिक सेक्टर को उसकी निजीकरण करते जा रहे हो और ये हालत हो गई कि लोग खरीदने की शक्ति ना होने की वजह से कारखाने अब बंद हो रहे हैं आपके ऑटोमोबाइल इंडस्ट्री में ही अनुमान है कि 20 लाख के करीब जो मजदूर थे उनकी छटनी हुई आपके अब टेक्सटाइल सेक्टर में 30 लाख के करीब छटनी हुई तो ये सब उनकी नीतियों के प्रतिफल है ना क्या करना चाहिए आप दिए हैं और राहत बड़े बड़े अमीरों को पूंजीपतियों को 2,15,000 करोड़ की ये 2,15,000 करोड़ अगर वो उसको सरकारी निवेश करती है हमारी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को बनाती है जो बहुत ज़रूरी है देश में तो करोड़ों की तादाद में नए नौकरियों की सृष्टि होगी और वो नए नौकरियों की जब सृष्टि होगी उनके हाथ में जब पैसा आएगा वेतन उसको जब खर्च करने लगेंगे तब जो है मांग बढ़ेगी और ये बंद कारखाने खुलेंगे ये रास्ता है साफ सबने लेकिन ये करेंगे नहीं क्योंकि उनके बड़े बड़े पूंजीपति दोस्तों को मदद देनी है वो उसी को मदद देते हुए ये हालत बना दी
हमारा संघर्ष जिंदाबाद
जिंदाबाद जिंदाबाद
मोदी सरकार हो बर्बाद
हो बर्बाद हो बर्बाद
आर्थिक मंदी की जिम्मेदार मोदी सरकार हो बर्बाद
हो बर्बाद हो बर्बाद
आर्थिक मंदी की जिम्मेदार मोदी सरकार हो बर्बाद
हो बर्बाद हो बर्बाद
कोई कोई फैक्ट्री ऐसे है कि हफ्ते का 3 दिन का काम है अब पूरे 6 दिन का 7 दिन का काम नहीं मिल रहा है पहले तो ओवर टाइम भी लग जाती थी अब वो भी नहीं लग रहा है बंद कर देते हैं कि भाई काम नहीं चल रहा है आगे माल नहीं जा रहा है तो महिलाएं बहुत परेशान हैं महिलाएं भी घर बैठी हैं
आर्थिक मंदी की जिम्मेदार
That's all we have here at New Delhi's Parliament Street. Now we go back to studio for more stories in this show.
For our next story, we go to South Africa. The motor industry sector in the country, which has a workforce of over 300,000, is inching closer to a strike action. The National Union of Metal Workers of South Africa, or NUMSA, will be meeting with the Commission for Conciliation, Mediation and Arbitration, that is CCMA, on October 23rd to discuss the picketing rules. Following this, the union can seek a certificate of non-resolution from this dispute settlement body as the last meeting with the employer held on October 11th proved to be fruitless. This meeting was the last of the series of meetings that make up the compulsory arbitration process that the union has to undertake before engaging in a strike action. At this meeting, the employers sought an agreement which would raise the workers' wages over a 3-year period, but only on the condition that NUMSA raises no other dispute during this period. NUMSA has refused to accept such a condition. Once the certificate of non-resolution is issued by the mediation body, indicating that all other means of resolving the dispute have been exhausted, NUMSA can officially notify the employers about a strike action. The previous wage agreement with the employers in the motor industry sector lapsed in August this year. As a part of the new agreement, which has been under negotiation since June, NUMSA has been demanding an across-the-board wage hike of 12%. At the last meeting arbitrated by CCMA on October 11th, the employers made a counter-offer to raise the wages in a phased manner over a three-year period. The employers are represented by three bodies: the National Employers Association of South Africa, the Retail Motor Industry Organization, and the Fuel Retailers Association. However, this offer made by the employers is conditioned upon a peace clause, which if accepted would imply that NUMSA forfeits its right to raise other demands to address issues such as employees' benefits and working conditions. These are demands the employers have refused to engage with. These demands include the 600 rand or $40 monthly travel allowance and a night shift allowance for those working at odd shifts. The latter is mandated in the Basic Conditions of Employment Act. Acceptance of the peace clause would in effect require NUMSA to drop these demands for the next 3 years until expiry of the new wage agreement. NUMSA has therefore rejected the company's offer and chosen to escalate towards an industrial action instead. The union said in a statement that our members made it clear that we cannot accept any agreement which does not improve working conditions. It further said that illnesses due to exposure to petrol fumes are common among fuel station workers. In a memorandum addressed to the Department of Minerals and Energy, NUMSA demanded medical aid and insisted that workers should not be expected to pay medical expenses as a result of exposure to petrol fumes caused by their occupation. And this is all we have in this episode of Around the World in 8 Minutes. For more such stories and videos, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you for watching.